Hello, I'm Dr. K. Rameshwari, principal of University College of Science and Technology, and also the coordinator of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Central Library of Adikavinanai University. And today I'm happy that we are celebrating the National Library Day on the 12th August in commemoration of the birth anniversary of the father of library sciences, Padma Shri Dr. S.R. Ranganathan. And I am happy to inform you that this is the first time that we are celebrating the National Library Day, and this has been possible because of the constant encouragement that our Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor Mokka Jagannath Rao sir is providing us, not only the faculty but also the students, in their academic pursuit and looking into the overall growth of the institution. And I am happy to inform you that on this occasion our Honorable Vice Chancellor was the chief guest of this program, and the guest of honor was our Registrar Professor B. Gangarao Garu, and in the presence of our invitees. Library is not only a source for formal education, but also it is a platform where it gives us the perception of life for different readers in different modes of concepts that they take in. And it is also a place where creativity and ideas and innovativeness of the students and also the individual human beings develop, where the books play an important role. And in this concept, I think the university having a big library, it is important to make the students and scholars and also the faculty members about the usage of library to the utmost extent, so that it not only fulfills their knowledge acquiring situation, but also to pursue the other aspects which are important for holistic development of the human being.
Exams or preparing for any other seminars or writing papers, etc. So in this way, the library is like a home, and it is like a second home for all of us. And in fact, more work, academic work is done and knowledge is acquired from these libraries, whether it is the V.S. Krishna Library or the library where I used to study at the University of Alaska Fairbanks. Like that, when Professor Gangaram said, when we are outside the country, leaving family, I left my son who is just born, and he was just a few days old. I left for years, and naturally we had a lot of homesick and emotional feelings. So when to overcome that, I used to spend much time in the library, because as the libraries are open 24 hours, so I used to spend much time in the library, especially in the weekends. The Friday, the weekend starts on the Friday evening there in the US. So all my roommates and hospital, they're playing huge music and all. They used to start drinking and all. So to avoid that, I used to go to the library and I used to spend time there. In that way, it gave me a lot of knowledge, a lot of information and commitment towards academics, etc. In this way, library, when I think about library, I have some kind of some energy flow into my mind. So I feel our university library should also do well. When you think about Professor Ranganathan, who is happen to be the father of library science, but actually he is a mathematician, I could understand. He has done a lot of work in mathematics, and that has slowly turned into a library professional, library expert, and library researcher. And as he said, he proposed some of the laws for the library. When I see those laws, I could not understand actually. So that's why I got these laws. Just everyone should know, there are five laws of library science. The first law we can understand, books are for use. Okay, you understand that. Every reader is / her book. Who do not understand properly? Every book, comma, its reader. Save the time of the reader. Okay, we'll understand that. A library is growing organism, no, not organization, it's organism. So these are the things. Do you have any idea about that? To explain these things. Before that, I got the meaning of that also. Instead of you, I can explain the laws. Books are used. The first law constitutes the basis for the library services. Dr. Ranganathan observed that books were often chained to prevent their removal, and then the emphasis was on storage and preservation rather than use. That is wrong.
Oxford University.
He did not reject the notion that preservation and storage are important, but he asserted that the purpose of the book is to promote its use. Without user access to books, there is little value for these items. By emphasizing use, Dr. Ranganathan refocused the attention of the field to access related issues. That is first thing. The second law is every reader, his or her book. The second law of library science, every reader, his or her book, means that librarians are to serve a wide collection of patterns, acquire literature to fit a wide variety of needs, and refrain from judging what specific patterns choose to read. Librarians should respect that everyone is different and that everyone has different tastes regarding the books they choose. Every book, its reader. Third law. Every book, its reader means all books have a place in the library, even if only a small demographic might choose to read them. Maybe only 10 people read one book, but still it should be there in the library. It is not based on the number of people using books. So our chalot lesser, and the pencil, and one book. And the books you don't have. Because it is not any place of commercial application. It's a place of repository of books. And the books are not there. Fourth law, save the time of the reader. The fourth law of library science, save the time of the user, means that all patrons should be able to easily locate the materials they desire quickly and efficiently. That's what he has done all this lifetime. How to locate a book? If I say one book, geology, petrology, and petrogenesis, you should be able to go within no time.
Access
we can access our numbers, so a misplaced item will be better now when these hot copies are there. The library must be a growing organism. The fifth law of library science, the library must be a growing organism, means that a library should be a dynamic institution that is never static in its outlook. Books, methods and physical library should be updated over time. Every time it is being updated, it is a very dynamic, that's why it is called an organism. So anyway, I'm happy today we are celebrating this, and with his inspiration, let us hope we download library many fold and see that the library will be bubbling with activity, students come and study. Even when the college is open, I never have seen much students flowing into library, and there is no activity like our library in B.S. Krishna. So we need to inculcate the students to utilize the resources. So all the teachers should encourage students to go to the library and study. Otherwise all this infrastructure and investment and whatever development we do will go waste when there are no uses. So we need to, your job is not only the maintenance and acquiring books, your job is to see all the stakeholders use this library for which the library is established, for which purpose it is established. That is to be fulfilled. Otherwise whatever you acquire, whatever you establish, whatever you do is a waste. So I sincerely request all the people connected with the library as well as all the teachers to encourage the students to utilize this so that the library's purpose is fulfilled. Thank you very much.